Hello, everybody. It's Friday, the end of our third week of social drawing. So I thought it'd be fun today to draw Dumbo. He's a cute little guy, and we can manage to draw the whole body in one class. So I'm going to keep the intro short to make sure we have time for that. I'm Michael Woodside. I'm an animator. People ask me who this is for. The answer is anybody who wants to learn how to draw or take their mind off of everything that's going on right now. This helps. This is a nice thing because it's a little achievable goal. We're going to listen to some nice music, and we're going to draw a really cute character. So we'll be thinking about a different fun thing for a bit. We're learning how to draw Pluto. I said Pluto. We're learning how to draw Dumbo. I'm losing my mind. It's been 3 weeks. What's going to happen next? Dumbo. And he's got a lot of great shapes. So it might be a little weird. They're big shapes. It might feel like your drawing is off as you're drawing it, but just finish it. Get to the end of the drawing and then you'll see how close it is. And it's probably a lot closer than you think it might be. For supplies, I'm just using regular pencils. I have this blue pencil to do my under drawing and then a black one to do my outer drawing. And I just separate that so that you can see the different steps more clearly for the video. Before we start drawing, before we really get into it, I like to clean, sanitize my hands. You can use soap or just hand sanitizer. That's what I'm using. So let's get that going. 3 weeks into this, it's cool to see how many people are joining in. If you follow the Drawing with Woodsy hashtag, you can see that there's a ton of people every day that are either drawing the new character or going back and drawing old ones. So that's great to see. And I hope you'll add your drawing to the mix. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm gonna move the camera over here. Great. Focus on that. Okay, so as we get started, the first thing I always do is do a bunch of warm-up circles. And what that does is that makes sure that our hands are kind of ready to go for the day. A lot of people haven't drawn yet today, so this is a good way to get started. Another thing this does, which is really nice, is that sometimes people are afraid to put the first line down. This is called the blank page fear. And what this does is this already kind of ruins the blank page. We have these little circles that just sort of don't make it look perfect anymore. So we're allowed to make some mistakes on the drawing and figure it out as we go. I think a lot of people assume that if you have talent in drawing, it's something that you're born with, or that a certain, you know, like, well, I just can't draw. But I don't think that's true. I think anyone can learn how to draw. They're pretty simple principles that you can just build off of and practice. It's like anything else. So it's like saying, well, I don't know how to drive. I can never learn how to drive. Like, you could figure it out. So as we're drawing these circles, I just want to point out why we do two different colors. So once I pick this line as my final line, I'm just going to start outlining it here. And then what that does is that helps define which lines we're actually going to be paying attention to. And the ones that are behind it just sort of fade away into the background. So these take the focus and then the blue lines go away. So for Dumbo, we're going to be drawing the whole body, and we want a lot of space on the side for his ears. So when we eventually get in there and draw Dumbo's head, we want to put it with enough room on either side. And his head is a different kind of head shape than we drawn before. He's got a really tall head. So we're going to show you how to start that. Okay, so I'm going to put Dumbo right here in the middle, knowing that his ears are going to be on either side. So let's draw this first circle. So it's going to be here. I'm going to tilt the desk up a little bit to give you a better angle. Pretty versatile desk. I love it. Shape this, sorry. Okay. In your back. Okay. I just want to make sure that you can see what we're doing because he's can be a little smaller to start off with. Okay, so this circle that I've made is the top of the head, but he has another circle for the bottom of the head. And it's gonna be bigger than this circle, and the top of the next circle is gonna pass through the middle of this one. So if it's bigger than that, I'm just gonna start slowly, knowing that this is gonna be the top, kind of build it out this way. One of the cool things about drawing with blue is that he's kind of a gray blue inside, so I know that these lines are gonna for sure disappear once we move on. Okay, so now I have these two circles, one on top of the other. That's a great start for Dumbo. The next thing I wanna do, we're gonna start with the center line. So that's gonna be a vertical line. He's gonna be looking right at us. So it's gonna be right down the middle. And then now the horizontal line, it's almost the size of this ping pong ball. It's gonna be pointing right at us, but it's gonna be lower than this one, probably more towards the bottom half, like that. And when I do these lines, I go in long strokes so that they don't wobble. If I go slower, then it's a little, it just feels kind of cautious and scared, but if I just go big strokes, it's okay to be wrong. You can kind of correct it with a bunch of extra lines. Okay, so let's put one of my favorite parts of him is his little chubby cheeks. So we're gonna give him his chubby cheeks first. They're gonna be starting from here. Pull out from the circle. And then kind of arc right back down towards the bottom of the circle like that. Do the same thing on this side. And I leave some space in the middle because this is where his trunk is going to go, so I'm not really connecting these. So now we can actually start working towards the top of the head. If you want, something I will do is actually leave the space in the middle disconnected, so I'm not going to draw a line that connects these two. I'm just kind of loosely indicating a straight line down from the side of the circle. And then darkening the top here. I'm doing the same thing over here, loose line, straight down. And as I'm pushing my pencil up, I'm pulling it away from the paper so that I get these lines that start thick and then go thin. So that is how I'm getting that kind of fade away. Okay, let's give Dumbo his eyes, and that'll help us know where the trunk goes. So the eyes are like circles that are squished in, they're ovals. And then each eye is very slightly rotated away from center. So his eye that's on the left side of the page is rotated a little bit left, and then the eye that's on the right is rotated a little bit right. So those are about halfway between here and here on top of that line. And then I'll do about the same distance on this side. I love this music from Pocahontas. Pocahontas is such a great score. He's got these great little cheeky cheeks. I'm gonna give him some cheeky cheeks. Those are curved lines that are right at the bottom of the eyeballs that start around where the center line is and pull up towards the side of the circle. So let's give him his trunk. I'm gonna start on this side, and his cheeks are really round. So actually, normally we draw the mouth corners like this, but his cheeks are so round because he's a baby, we're actually gonna do it this way. So that makes it feel like it's a fatter cheek. So we're gonna give him one of those lines here. And it's related to this, you know,
all this, it's all based on the same shapes, but we really only see the bottom part turn up like that. Okay, now the trunk. So the trunk is gonna go down below the head, and it's gonna be a little, we're calling it favoring the left-hand side, and by favoring, that just means that most of the shape of it is gonna be on the left side. So if somebody was standing out like this, their hand on their hip, go fast drawing. And they're favoring the left side because most of their stuff is, most of their body is on the left side of the center. So that's what we mean by that. So starting from here, I'm gonna draw a really stretched out diagonal S curve. Remember all the S curves we've been drawing? So imagine that S is just pulled this way and this way. It's turned into that. And then at the bottom of that S, I'm going to overlap it with a little circle. And that lets us know where the end of the trunk is. And then from here, I'm just going to grab a line and then get to the end of the circle that we just made. So you can make it straight, you can make it a little curved. I'll darken this area back here. And it's tucked in behind this. That's why we see that this line is in front. It's kind of rolled back, overlapping it behind it. There's a couple little detail lines we can put up here just to finish him off. He's got a bump right in the middle. And a few more down the middle of the trunk. So you just throw some lines in there. Okay. Next, we're going to start with the legs. So the legs go, actually start from right underneath the cheeks and then land just below the feet. So I'm going to draw where the feet are first. I know it's a little weird, but a lot of times I like drawing where things end up so that I know that I'm not going to go too far. So I'm just going to draw these ovals down here. And they're going really lightly because they're not going to be the final feet. They're just telling me where the end point is. So taking things out from the cheek, I'm just going to draw lightly a straight line down to the feet. And then this just goes right up to the trunk. Let's do the same on the other side. So there's some fun little details on the feet, so that's why we're going really light, because we're gonna build on those details. So here, I'm just gonna draw a little bump to show that the foot is in front of the leg. And I'll do the same thing on the other side. And then I can darken in this line. That reminds me, actually, one last thing we can do on the face now that we're up by the cheeks. I'm gonna give him a little lip. So that's just a small line on this side, and then on this side. This keeps him feeling young. Okay, let's do the similar kind of feet on the other side. And if you want, you can add another little overlap down there. Chunky little feet. got these really great little toenails that I want to make sure we get. And the easiest way to do that is you can just draw little circles, or it could be ovals down here, one over there, and then one on the side. And this one is smaller than that one because the foot is wrapping around and going away from us in space. I'm gonna do the same thing on this side. Little toesies. And what we don't see, it could be a little confusing, but we know that his body is back here. His arms are just sort of connecting behind his cheek. So we can add little lines here to show that there's a body, but not a lot of detail there because he's young and he's got a lot of plump baby fat. Okay, now we're gonna do the back feet. So the back feet are, he's sitting in this pose. And if we were to see him from the side, he would be like this. This would be what his body looks like. So we're gonna put those feet here by doing little circles. And then just connecting it with a diagonal line back into the body, like that. If you haven't seen Dumbo in a while, it's a really surprising movie. I don't remember seeing it the same way when I was a kid, but it has a lot of great animation in it. It's really simple. I think it's short too. It's only like 70 minutes or something, but it's a cute movie. A lot of great artwork in it. So the same thing that we did here with these foot bumps, I'm going to do that on this one. Give them some depth. So this is the very bottom of the foot, and then there's just a little bit of foot meat, baby foot meat. Gross. He's also got toenails, so let's just go ahead and finish off this foot with some circles. I have mine slanted like that, because it's in perspective, it's going away from us. So they're kind of like slanted this way. So now we can do the other foot. It's a similar kind of thing. Circle. And this connects in here. A lot of people requested to draw Dumbo, and I'd never drawn it before, so it was fun to go in and figure out how he's put together. A lot of really round shapes. So now I'm going to do the other leg, just to make it different than this one. This one has kind of a slope like this. We're going to do the other one kind of the other direction, give him a knee. So I'm going to round out this way and then go in. And the last line for the body that we want to add is how these feet, we imagine they connect behind all of him. So, see, I'm just going to draw sort of lightly through everything. So right about there, I'm going to darken that. And this is like where his booty's on the ground. Okay, so let's go back to the face. He's got these unique eyebrows. Not a lot of characters that have eyebrows like him. It's pretty fun to draw. It's simple. It's just one line and then another line right next to it. And they're parallel to each other, which means they're going the same direction. So I'll show you here. Is that towards the top of the bottom circle. And now, same thing we've done before, I'm gonna sharpen my pencil. We go a little darker on the top of his eyes to give him the little eyelashes. actually, he has little eyelashes, so I like drawing those lines here. So I'm just giving him three little curved lines. The light over here so you can see it better. Little baby. He's also got these little hairs that stick up on top of his head here. Just remember how we did this earlier where we press and then let go? He just has three little hairs up top like that. So you can practice over here. I'm slowly letting them fall to the right so they're not, those aren't parallel. These are kind of like that. So practice as much as you need over here. Almost Dumbo, right? We're missing two very important things here. Let's give him those ears. No more procrastinating. Okay, so his ears are huge, so we left a lot of room on either side. And the ears are, remember this S shape that we drew here? It's gonna be the same kind of thing, where it's gonna go down, up, and over. Top of the ear. Now it doesn't come to a point. Nothing really in Dumbo comes to a point. I almost called him Pluto again. This is Dumbo. It rounds out at the top. It kind of comes back a little bit. But it doesn't stay going that way. He's got these. The bottom of his ears are bigger than the top. So it comes right back out. And then now I'm going to draw where it connects, which is going to be. I put it a little higher on the foot because it shows that it's behind the ear back here. So if we see it from the side, the ear would be back here. And if there's a ground plane, it's further back this way. So we want to draw the connection point back here, and that lets us know that it's farther back in space. It's a really helpful tool if you're drawing in perspective. And then we just round it back up and connect into the ear. Thing's huge. Probably made mine too big, but I think they're cuter when they're big. And then the last line for this ear, we're gonna do, if you remember for Pua, he had, let's draw the Pua down here. So he had this ear that went up and then down, and then the inside of the ear was this kind of arc. It's gonna be the same kind of thing, but just a little more shallow. So it's gonna go up there and connect almost down to where the cheek is. Cool. So the same thing happens on the other side. It's almost like you take this one and flip it over this way. So we're gonna go down. I'm going to do a little faster on this one because we drew it before and I have some experience with it, so I'm familiar with it. And then now, because we drew this line, we're going to do the reverse on the other side. So to actually do his eyes, he's got really, really, really baby blue eyes. So I'm gonna go to a different pencil for that, just so we can keep it separated. And I'm just gonna draw circles right down here in the bottom. And for Dumbo, not that he needs to be crossed, but if his eyes are crossed, that could be cute. So he does have pupils, but I'm gonna color these in all the way blue. And then when we get to the dark line, we can decide whether or not we're going to give him pupils. Look how cute. Okay, so Let's go ahead and get started with the dark line. I'm going to use this pencil. This is a soft pencil, so it has a great line. And I'm going to probably cover up the sheet of paper if I need to, so I don't smudge it. I'm right-handed, so I'm going to start on the left side of the drawing and then work across this way. And once we get it all the way outlined, then I can go in and color it. Okay, so let's start on this side of the ear. Dumbo's a great character. Even if you don't want to draw the body, like when you're drawing him later, and you just draw the head and the ears, so cute, so much fun to draw. So thank you everyone who suggested Dumbo. A lot of times when people suggest characters, I look online to see if other poses have been done so I don't teach the same pose. Sometimes for the classic characters, it's best to teach the straight on pose because that helps understand exactly how to draw them and then you can put them in other poses. But as for these characters that are sort of lesser drawn, I like picking poses that are just actually pulled from the film. So this is when Dumbo is first introduced. And his ears pop open. A brand new baby Dumbo. So what's cool about this class is you actually get to learn how to draw an animation drawing. So it's not just a model drawing, but it's usually poses that are taken from the film. So this line that's down in the bottom, I'm going to draw thicker than the rest. Kind of has the feeling of a shadow, and that helps give it some depth. When I started doing these classes, I had literally no expectation that anyone would watch. It was just something I thought would be fun to do and help take my mind off of everything. And it's been so cool to see how people also need to take their mind off in the same way and have come along. So if you've been around the whole time, if you just started, I appreciate you being here. And what you don't know is while I'm doing this, I'm still working. We're working from home for Disney Animation, so when we're not recording, I'm working on some upcoming films that we're not allowed to talk about. So it's cool to be able to do this in some downtime. We're not too much detail on these parts, so just do it softly. Darker there. Okay. So even though we're not live, just so we can get a better video quality, I still feel like we're pretty connected when everyone posts their drawings. I'm always looking right about 1 o'clock in California time to see how it turned out. Sometimes when you're animating on a film, it takes forever to find out if people like it or if you did a good job. Because you might work on something and then months later it shows up in theaters. And I always tell people it's like telling a joke and then waiting 6 months to find out if there was a laugh, which is crazy. So what's cool about this is that I can just do it one day, and then the next day everyone gets to see it. We're so used to, you know, so much time in between. That is personally exciting for me. Okay, so let's do this last little thing, and then we'll do the eyes. So for the eyes, I'm gonna bring in this sheet of paper so that I am not smudging anything. I'm gonna wait to do the pupil if we're gonna do it until later. And these little guys. So I'm just going back and thickening out some lines that I can't really see. Okay, so to color him in, I'm gonna try this pencil. I might try it on the side. This is a different pencil. It is a gray blue, cool gray. Dumbo is kind of a gray, but he's also kind of a blue. So let's see, maybe this is, let's see, a little green. I'll go back to my blue. Color him lightly. Let's find a good song to color him in with. All right, mamas, hold your babies close. Such a good song. I'll go back to the regular scores. So I just colored in his body blue, and I'm gonna color in the bottom of his feet a little darker. So I'm just pressing harder. I'm not a mom, I'm not a baby anymore, but that song. So I left the toenails because we're going to color those in differently, kind of with a little pinkish kind of color. I just have my red, and I'm going to use that and color in lightly. Let's sharpen it. And the ears are a little pink, so I'm just going to really lightly use the side of my pencil and go pretty quickly. So that it's not too precious. Who knows Dumbo? Who is precious? Hopefully you never felt like you wanted to throw it away. It's Friday. It should be calming. It should just be fun. Drawing is great because you have a goal. And I think right now there's a lot of confusion and maybe some anxiety. And what's nice about this is that you have some time to just say, I'm going to draw Dumbo. And at the end of this, I'm going to have a picture that looks like Dumbo. And you will. Most people do. And what's cool about that is that a lot of people about 10 minutes into this are joking about how theirs doesn't look right or looks like a different kind of character. But by the end, people find it. And that, I think, makes me happy because I'm trying to find ways of describing how to draw it that are universal and kind of good for any age. So it's not just for kids. It's not too advanced for kids. And that hopefully people can, I don't want it to be frustrating, which is why we switched to pre-recorded so that the video quality didn't get in the way of you guys having a good time with it. So while I like the live part, I prefer you're able to see the drawing that we're doing. Okay, so that's that. I want to look at it and decide if I want to color in the eyes with a pupil. I think I'm going to do it. So his pupil, just a little smaller circle inside the circle. Yeah, this is cute. And when I color that in, I'll do it bigger on the side so you can see it. If this is the eyes, I do a couple of these circles to show you some options. You'll notice that I did the pupil more towards the side and not right in the middle. Right in the middle is fine, but it can sometimes look a little crazy if we just see all of it. So this is right in the middle. If it was like that, he might look a little scared because we see the whole thing. But what's nice about Dumbo, if you watch it back, they do these things where they might put the pupil way off to the side here. He's looking in this direction. So since he's cute little cross-eyed baby. I added that in there. And just by getting a little more distance between the pupil and the iris than over on this side, that gives it a little more appeal. So the pupil is down more towards the middle for me. Lastly, I'm gonna do a little bit of shading on the ground since we wanna show that he's flat on the ground. So I'm taking the outline pencil that I used and then just making just horizontal lines. So I'm not going diagonal or vertical, just horizontal lines right in the middle and then out to the side, kind of stopping at the foot. Same thing here. And then if you want to go back and make it a little darker where it's closer, always horizontal. It's a new technique for us. We haven't done this, but I do this all the time. If you look back on my Instagram, there's a ton of drawings where I have some shading like this. And that, I believe, is Dumbo. So before we're done, we have to make sure that we sign our drawings. So I'm going to put my signature down here. So if you did this drawing and you'd like to share it with the world, tag hashtag drawing with Woodsy, and then everyone will see what you've worked on. At the end of the day, I always go back and take a look at the stories people have sent to me that I restory to them, and just see how everyone's characters turned out. So share your drawing so that you can be a part of that for everybody. Even if you're drawing this alone in your home, you're really not alone because everyone is drawing together. It's kind of cool. It's crazy. All right. Oh, you know what? I think I'm going to do one little thing. Since he's a baby, I'm going to very, 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 very lightly go on top of the cheeks and give him little rosy cheeks. It's so light. I don't know if you can see it on my drawing, but if you do it on yours, you'll see it. And it might be worth practicing on the side so you don't go too dark. But I just like sort of hinting at the rosy cheeks. So, great. That, my friends, is Dumbo. Cool. So let's go ahead and finish up. I'm going to bring you back over here. Ooh.
Sure, you can see everything that's going on. Dumbo is fun to draw, and he is nice and peaceful, which I appreciated on Friday, right before the weekend. I hope you had a good time. Don't forget, now that we're done drawing, you clean your hands off, because you probably have pencil smudges all over your hands. I do, always. And don't forget to sign your drawing if you haven't yet. Tag it on Instagram or Twitter with Drawing with Woodsy. And you could tag me in the drawing as well, and I'm Woodsy. That's it. I hope you have a great weekend. This is 3 weeks in. I plan on going next week, so I'll see you then. And just remember, because we're separated doesn't mean we have to be alone. So thank you again for spending this week with me, and I'll see you next week. Bye now.